I'm going to introduce people here. We want a nice, loud round of applause for the warriors at the table and also the people getting them prepared into the ring. So I'm going to start off with two young men back on the card on Saturday night. Loads of support and in big fights for their futures, of course, and flying the flag for Boxing Hold. Please give a round of applause for Connor Seymour and Carl Chadwick. A young man that is definitely not used to Hull and training very hard out with Luke Campbell and Jorge Rubio in Miami, a very talented, undefeated young fighter who is here to experience boxing in the UK and Hull. Please make one of our visitors this week very welcome. It's Jacob Woolley. On the left, two gym mates who have travelled from Mexico to disrupt the plans and achieve dreams of becoming world champions. Firstly, I'd like a round of applause, please, for a young fighter who I've watched plenty of footage on, very exciting, and here to have a big challenge on Saturday night against Hull's Luke Campbell. Please welcome from Mexico, Jairo Lopez. And we're blessed to have some great trainers in the UK, but we have two great international trainers here with us this week, and two guys who anyone who knows their boxing knows are some of the very best trainers in world boxing. Of course, with Luke Campbell, a man who has really picked up the mantle and taken control of Luke after that loss against Yvonne Mendy. He packed his bags, he went out to Miami, he sacrificed lots of things to make sure that he got the best preparation moving forward in his career. I'd like to show some respect for Nacho Bernstein and for Jorge Rubio, please. As trainers goes in the UK, a man who's going to be extremely busy in the next 2 weeks, of course, what a wonderful achievement. Working with Gavin McDonald to try and capture this WBC world title on Saturday night, and next Saturday in the Lions Den at the O2. Trying to guide Tony Bellew to victory against David Hay in a huge British blockbuster. Just from down the road, of course, looking to do Yorkshire proud on Saturday's Dave Colbert. A man who you can always guarantee will give you every inch of his soul and plenty of entertainment in the ring. But I believe a much improved fighter. I thought he had a fantastic fight against Tyrone Nurse for the British light welterweight title last time out. He's had some incredible nights at the arena and at the KC Stadium as well. He's here to do it all again on Saturday night, and that's Hull's very own Tommy Coyle. Like I said, based a lot in Miami these days, but his heart and soul will always remain in this city. Huge support again on Saturday night. Now really approaching that crunch time shot at the world title. That's your Olympic gold medalist and 135-pound, soon-to-be world champion, Luke Campbell. Now, this is a story and a half. As I said, 3 years ago, we were sitting here talking about a fight with Lee Wood and Gavin McDonald. I remember the quotes that Gavin McDonald used at our press conference, which was basically, this would be an absolute, it's a dream to fight for the British title, not just win a British title. And he's gone from area champion to English champion to British champion. He then went on to win the European title, which was a great night and a great achievement, but did it with a breeze, with a canter. Moved up on the WBC silver title, has now boxed on some of the biggest shows in the UK. And on Saturday night, he has a chance to become WBC World Super Bantamweight Champion. From Doncaster down the road, sold a huge amount of tickets, and this is an unbelievable story. He could become world champion with his twin brother Jamie, also the current WBA bantamweight world champion. I remember 3 years ago, his little boy screaming at the back there was screaming at the front in a buggy, and it's been a great journey. And Steffi Ball at the back, part of this story. And I'll tell you, on Saturday night, you've got to get behind this kid, because this is what dreams are all about. And that's from Doncaster, challenging for the WBC world title on Saturday, Gavin McDonald. Okay, we're going to pass over to the guys. Firstly, Jacob, welcome. We know this isn't quite Miami, but Hull is clearly better. And I'm sure excited to fight on these shores on Saturday night.
No, I really am, and I greatly appreciate the opportunity, Eddie, and thank the trainer and my stablemate, also Luke, for helping me get ready through this camp, and I'm very excited for this fight. I'm looking forward to making some fans here in the UK.
You're going to enjoy it. You're going to love the atmosphere. Connor, obviously you've boxed at the arena a number of times, and a big fight for you on Saturday night, and one to get through and push forward into titles in 2017.
Yes, definitely. I've recently fought this fight. I had my first eight rounder. I'm looking forward to getting another win on Saturday. Preparation has gone really well, and then progress on to major titles later this year, beginning of next year.
And Carl as well, big support for you again. The Ice Arena, always a special night. Changing room's not the best, but atmosphere second to none.
Yeah, to be fair, I can't see it being the warmest in there with it being Ice Arena. It's just one place and all I haven't fought yet. How can you pass it up when gentlemen like yourself are giving me the opportunity? I just want to step up to the plate. So thank you. Thanks to everyone else for helping me, all my support. And let's have another good fight on Saturday night from all the lads and all. Thank
good you. Man. I miss this gentleman out for a reason, because this is a hell of a story. And I know he's shy, I don't want to embarrass him too much. But Dave Allen, this is a great story, right? So Dave Allen is a heavyweight prospect. Most of you know him because of his last two very high profile fights from Sheffield in Yorkshire. A lot of talent. Anyone that's sparred him will tell you, a very, very tough man. Didn't really get the guidance that he needed. And therefore, as fighters do, they've got to fight. And they don't care who they fight, they need to get paid, and they'll fight anybody. And when a fighter isn't particularly looked after, they make most of the decisions. And the answer is always yes. Will you fight Dylan White on 2 weeks' notice? Yeah. Will you fight Luis Ortiz, the number one heavyweight in the world, in 3 weeks' notice? Yeah. And that's what Dave Allen did. So we've decided that actually, I think Dave Allen can be a top heavyweight. And I think he can go on and win British titles. So we're going to just move backwards from two very good, respectful performances against Dylan White and Luis Ortiz and actually start to plan a career for Dave Allen. Because I tell you what, it's a great challenge. Because I think he can go out and I think he can go and win British titles. And it starts on Saturday night in Hull Arena, where he's going to go out there and rather have a mentality of fighting a number one heavyweight in the world, we want him to go out, look explosive. So before he talks, I have to take my hat off to this man. I have a huge amount of respect, a real fighting man. A big round of applause, please, for Dave Allen. And now you've got to talk, Dave. I've seen you on Instagram Live, and you talk all night. So don't shy away. Ready for Saturday night, and hopefully a W on the record.
Yeah, first of all, I just want to say thank you, Eddie. That's nice. Secondly, you know, a lot of people say that Eddie threw me to the wolves. No, I threw myself to the wolves. Firstly, because I'm very impatient, I just want to fight the best. I did believe I'd beat Dillian White, but no, I didn't. Did I think I'd beat Luis Ortiz? Probably not, but I just wanted to give it a go. I probably did think I was going to beat him. That's how crazy I am. I thought, I don't need to train to beat these heavyweights. I just thought I'd go in there and I'd beat him, but obviously I didn't. But them two fights are the best thing that has happened to me. We're here now, you know, that's all behind us. Just forgot all about that. And I've had 12 fights, but like this, on Saturday night, this is like my first fight all over again. I'm starting again. I'm fighting Lucas the Plumber. I can't say his second name, so we're calling him Lucas the Plumber. I don't know what he's called. But he's a tough man, you know, but we're starting again. And we're Mick Marsden now. You know, the man's like, he's not here today, so I can say it. The man's like a dad to me, you know. We've got a close relationship going on. You know, I need to kick up the arse now, so he needs an arm around me as well. And, you know, Mick can do that. So, you know, I'm just very grateful that I'm here now. And it's all thanks to relative strangers really, off the internet that have kind of got where I am today. So, I'm really looking forward to Saturday. It's a big night, you know, it's only a six rounder against, like I say, it's Lucas fella that I don't know. But you know, this is bigger than Ortiz and White now. This is a must win and a must perform. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to it.
Thanks, Dave. Tommy Coyle. So you're gonna be fighting Kofi Yates originally. You knew exactly what to expect. Withdrawal from Cody Yates. Come up to probably a slightly tougher fight in Rakeem Noble. Certainly in terms of not knowing too much about your opponent. We know about him down in London. I spoke to London fighters. Very talented, very skillful, very durable, very fit. A big win over Kay Prosper, who I've got to say, I believe is one of the top prospects in the country. And a real crossroads fight for you, all about trying to win that Lonsdale belt, and an absolute must-win fight on Saturday night. For him, you've been there before, a golden opportunity to come up and try and kickstart his career and crack the big time. So for you, obviously, and Jamie Moore, whilst I know you're always out to entertain, a must-win fight on Saturday.
Thanks, mate.
Certainly, you know, it is a crossroads fight. I guess the winner will go on, you know, probably to fight for the British title. So that's a huge driving force and ambition for me. But, you know, fighting Kofi Yates, we knew what we was going to get. I know nothing about this guy, and that's not to be disrespectful. It's just been under the radar. But I've not been just preparing for this fight for the last 3 weeks. I've known I'm fighting him. Been in the game 21 years, I've had over 120 fights as an amateur and pro. And I'm sure that I will have come across many, many fighters that fight like this kid before. So, you know, I'm going to have to go in there, make an assessment, and go to work on him.
In your career, you've had some incredible ups and downs. I mean, of course, the Brizuela fight, the Derry Matthews fight, we can forget that one, the Luke fight, of course, the Katsidis fight, which was, again, an incredible night at the arena. The Tyrone Nurse fight, which I thought really could have gone either way, and I thought was a great performance from you in that fight. Is that just what we get from Tommy Gore? I mean, even in the Martin Gethin fight, where he withdrew, you know, pulled out with a busted eardrum, you were down, looked like you were out of the fight in that fight. Is it just something that we're just going to have to learn to accept that's what we're going to get from Tommy Gore? There's no routine wins, is there? Can we see a routine win on Saturday night? Is that even possible?
I don't know, I just do whatever I need to do to win. And listen, the defence isn't the greatest, everybody knows that. I refuse to lose. I have been beat, but I wouldn't have got beat if I had my...
Sí, claro, tenemos una gran oportunidad. Nos hemos preparado fuertemente para este compromiso, lo cual sabemos que vamos a salir a ganar. Hemos trazado una buena estrategia, lo cual el sábado vamos a emplear y a salir a ganar, y vamos a salir con la mano en alto.
Okay. Yes, we know that we have a great compromise to this fight, and we have a very strong, very hard prepared for this. We know that we are going to go to win this fight. We are going to become champion the Saturday night.
Thank you very much. Jorge, you've had a number of successful outings now, Jorge, with Luke. And tell us a little bit about this camp and the improvements that you've seen with Luke during the preparations.
Okay, I want to say, Eddie Hahn and Luke, thank you for giving the opportunity to Jericho to fight in this show, and thank you, you're doing a good job Saturday night. No, about it, I think that Jairo is a good opponent. He's a Mexican. When he's fighting, he's giving the life in Sancho, but we are ready for fighting, for win the fight Saturday night. We are ready. He did a good training camp in Miami. He did a good sparring, and we are ready. If he's ready for fight, we are ready for fight too. And Saturday night, go to say who is the winner. Saturday night. Okay.
Thank you. Luke, obviously, since the Mendy loss, it's been a long while since we've been in Hull. Obviously, August, the KC Stadium was the last time, back in 2015, incredibly. And of course, after you boxing in Sheffield against Gary Sykes, then in Leeds, then in Liverpool as well, yeah. You said to me at the end of it, we've got to get back to Hull, and you're really excited to be back here on Saturday night.
Yeah, very excited to be back here in front of the home crowd. You know, I was on the road all last year, and you know, it was a busy year. I had my head down a lot. I was away for a lot of months from my family, And you know, I want the best. I want to be the best. And you know, as a family decision, we decided that it'd be better to train with George and me doing my training camps away. And I think everybody's seen last year that each fight seen improvement after improvement, and each training camp just got better and better with George. We've got a fantastic relationship, and you know, we work really well together. And I feel myself improving constantly every time I'm with him. But most importantly, I'm enjoying what I do. I love what I do. And you know, come Saturday night, you're gonna see some more improvement from myself. And I'm excited to put Sean. We've had a great training camp. I went away just before New Year, left the family just before New Year, and started camp and ready to prepare for the best I can be come Saturday night.
And when you walk out there, like I said, in the arena, and you just get taken around the back there, it's that little walk-on area, and everyone's just like, it's like a rave, isn't it? You know, everyone's just there, they're climbing over the walk-on, there's beer everywhere, there's singing, there's dancing. That little walk-on at the whole ice arena is kind of special, isn't it? Because it's just nuts, and that's to Luke and to Tommy as well.
Yeah, I mean, it's crazy. Tommy will tell you himself that, you know, I don't believe that we get there anywhere else but here in Hull with our fan base, with all the people that come and support myself and Tommy. And it's just such a great atmosphere. You know, it's not the biggest venue, but when we fill it, the atmosphere is unreal, and you know, they really give us some great support. And you know, myself and Tommy will tell you, having that support going into the ring is an extra boost for us to
Yeah,
get up. But you know, it's you know, I want to impress. Not only do I train to win, but I also want to impress and get a great performance.
Good man. Look forward to your fight on Saturday night.
Thanks.
Nacho, you've been involved in lots of world title fights. Tell us about Ray Vargas and tell us what you expect from him on Saturday.
Esperamos una pelea difícil. La técnica del boxeador británico es un excelente peleador. Me parece un boxeador fino. Ray Vargas tiene un estilo similar. Creo que va a ser una pelea difícil de estrategia y aspiramos a ganar.
Good afternoon. We expect a very hard fight because we know the fighter is a very high class fighter. And we studied the style, and we have a strategy for that. But we expect a very hard fight because we know that he is a very, very good fighter. The British fighter is a very good fighter.
And to Ray Vargas, Ray, a big chance for you to become world champion on Saturday.
Así es, buenas tardes a todos. Una buena oportunidad, que hemos trabajado mucho por ella. Y bueno, no vengo de mi casa nada más a pasear, vengo a pelear. Sé que es un duelo de invictos, pero tengo la mentalidad bien puesta y sé lo que voy a hacer arriba del ring. Gracias.
Okay. I know it's a very hard fight for me. I had prepared for this fight. I know he's a very good fighter. I don't come here just to come to see around the city. I come to fight and hard to get that title to my country.
Thank you, Ray. Dave, start with a couple of weeks for you, and I know this one is something you're very proud of, putting some huge amount of work with Gavin McDonald, and what a chance on Saturday night. Britain's second WBC world champion, your second WBC world champion as well. A great fight, a tough fight, but one you believe you can win.
Yeah, I mean, for the last 20 months since I've been working with Gavin, it's only a short period of time in his whole career. We've got to look at where he's come from to where he is now. I remember way back when he was just a young kid boxing on Steffi's shows, and I watched this kid and I thought, I don't believe that he's going to be one of the names in British boxing.
you've got to look at the job that Steffi Bull's done over the years, the time, the effort, the money that he's put in on his small shows bringing him through. Steffi's his best mate, he's not just his manager. He's done a fantastic job on him, guiding him through, bringing him through his small shows, passing on to you promotionally, and the job that you've now done to bring him through. Everybody's done the bit. His old trainers, Steffi, I've come along, I'm doing a bit. All I can ask for any fighter that I work with is that they give 100% in every training session, in their life, everything. When they walk out the door, I can't do anything with them. He's got a good support network with his wife, make sure that he can get on with what he needs to do. Everybody's done the bit. Gavin McDonald now is a much more improved fighter than I could ever have hoped he could have been when he first walked through my doors for me to work with. Because he gives 100%. It might not be the most technically gifted, the most fluid boxer you'll ever see, but he's got an engine, he works, he grafts, he's an honest worker. You ask him to do something, you don't have to ask him twice. You don't have to ask him to step it up in training. You don't have to tell him, be careful with doing this, do that, multiple times. He's an honest pro. Is he kind of dream pro that you want to work with as a coach? And he's, this camp, the culmination of the last 20 months, it's not just about this camp. The culmination of the last 20 months of working together, the things we've been working on, just seem to fit in. Bit by bit, as the weeks have gone on, the sparring sessions have come on, Steffi's seen a few of them towards the end of the camp. The things that he's doing are the things that he needs to do to win the fight. He's showing how to win the fight. Now, a big thing about him is his concentration. His concentration, sometimes he'll let him down where he'll do some good work and then he'll allow the fighters to have success back. And then when he's getting caught, he feels he has to go again and walk straight back into trouble. He's learning because he's learning as a pro. What we've got to remember is that he never had any amateur fights. He's only 18 fights into his career, so he's learning as he's going on. But because he never had any amateur pedigree, if you're fighting a Luke Campbell as a prospect, because you know his amateur pedigree, you're an opponent, you're wearing and you think, this kid's good, I've got to watch for this, watch for that. You look at Gavin McDonald on television throughout his career, and he doesn't look like a superstar. It doesn't look like he does anything dangerous, anything explosive. He just goes in there, gets on with the job, comes out with a win. But everybody that's ever got in with him, right down, as Steffi will tell you, even down on his shows, at 6-round level, 8-round level, area title level, everybody that's got in the ring has thought they can beat him. And that experience for someone like Gavin is priceless, because you can have 20 fights, 28 fights as a pro, and majority of fighters that get in with you, because of hand-picked opponents, they think they've got no chance of winning, or they're going just to give it a go. There's a big difference between fighting people that want to give it a go and fighting people that expect to beat you. And if you can keep beating people consistently that you're not expected to beat and who believe they can beat you, they're real fighters, and real fights make real fighters. And I believe on Saturday night, the culmination of the kind of career that he's had, where he's always been the underdog, the work that he puts in day in, day out in the gym, and how he lives his life, and the sport network of the people around him, I believe that will come together, and on Saturday night he'll become world champion.
Kevin, I suppose you're tired of hearing, this is a fairy tale story, this is unbelievable, because on Saturday night, you've got to be world class to win this world title. The opportunity's here, you've done it completely the right way. Area titles, English titles, British titles, European titles, world title eliminators, and now we're just a couple of days away from the big moment. It'll be like Doncaster at the whole arena on Saturday night.
That's it. It's been some story from where we started. Back with Steffi down at Doncaster Dome, we had a lot of fights down there, built the name up, some good fights, some good wins. And then we come, Eddie and Macho, and we had the first fight, TV fight, against Lee Wood for the British title. And that was the start of the journey. And in all fairness, I would have been happy to retire after that fight, because I exceeded at the time a lot more than I thought I could. But obviously, as you get on the journey, you get better as a fighter. You pick your goalposts up and you move along, and that's all I've done. Each fight, take each fight as it comes, win that fight, pick the goalposts up. We won British, European, couple of international titles, and all against good kids, so I've got the experience along the way. And now now the next one is the WBC world title, which I can't say it's always been a lifelong dream, but it's been a dream since obviously I started back boxing in the early 20s, and that's the belt every fighter wants. I don't care who you are, the green belt's the belt you all want, and now it's there for me, and I plan on giving it 100%, and I know 100% I will come back and be the champion.
Obviously, Saturday night, 3,000 people, predominantly Yorkshiremen, extremely proud, the national anthem, the British flag. How important is it to stay in the moment on Saturday night and make sure that you take this opportunity?
I think it's just in you, it's built in you, Jack. I mean, you fight, there's no difference in the fight and the preparations and fight, it just comes second nature to you. And I think when I'm in there, I'm just too zoned in on the fight to take anything in, but it's a massive, massive chance, and you've just said there, it's the first time I thought I'm going to be in my own national anthem, so which is always a little bit of a bonus, it means I'm doing something right. And yeah, just can't wait to get in there and really put a show on and give the fans and everybody who's backed me along the way another night to remember.
Well, I remember sitting here 3 years ago for your TV debut. You could hardly get a word out of your mouth. You were that green. You sit there now, you look like a world champion. You look like someone who's ready to go. So let's go and do the fucking business on Saturday night. Gentlemen, I'm so excited about this show and so buzzed at this show, this atmosphere, this opportunity. And on Saturday night, let's get behind all of these lads. And our visitors included as well, show respect, because this is a great sport with great stories. And as Dave said there, a gentleman at the back, Steffi Bull, who's lived and breathed every second of this journey as well with Gavin McDonald. I know he's going to be very proud along with Gavin McDonald's family. It's a great story. Stories don't necessarily win fights. Skill, heart, determination win fights. So let's get behind everybody, and of course Gavin McDonald and all the whole lads on Saturday. Tomorrow the weigh-in is at 1 p.m. at the Princess Quay Shopping Centre. Get yourself there. I think there's like 40 or 50 tickets left for Saturday. Let's pack it out. Let's have a good sing-song and let's watch a great night of sporting entertainment. And then we're going to have to pose for photos up here now. Thanks for coming as always. Great to be back in Hull. Thank you.